I just want to show you all of this lemon balm. I harvested all that lemon balm out of the one garden bed. That was three small plants that I put in there last fall so that I could get some harvest before winter, because my lemon balm that was out near the fence didn't do well for me. So anyways, this just goes to show good soil. And not only that, but this was under a shade cloth, and the leaves, look how large the leaves are on this thing. Like, it just keeps growing and growing, and it hasn't flowered. It hasn't gone into flower or anything yet, and I've got all of these leaves. So the power's out in my house right now, and I guess that happened while I was outside harvesting. So I was gonna come in and wash everything, soak everything and wash everything. But I think what I'm gonna do is I'll wait till the power to come back on, because I don't want these to be all wet. Well, you know what? No. I will wash these and then I'm gonna dry them out. I'll put them out on a big, oh, I guess my laundry went off too, because I don't hear that going. I'll put them on a big towel, a big bath towel, and let them dry, but these are gonna get dehydrated. So look at that, nice. Always have your electronics charged to the fullest, because you never know when disaster strikes or power goes out and how long it's going to be out for, etc. And you always want to have communication available, which means that if you have a data plan on your phone, that's a very important thing to be able to use that, even if you have just enough to get you through emergency, and you just want to use it during emergency times. But I mean, if Wi-Fi isn't working and you don't have data plan, then you know, a lot of your internet communications and finding out what's going on isn't going to be available to you. So anyways, power's still out. It's going to be out for a couple of hours at least. I got all of the lemon balm stripped of its stems, and then I put it through the pot of water, did a good washing of it twice. And like, this actually wasn't very sandy. I got a couple of bugs. I got a Danny Long Leg spider and a couple of little tiny bugs that were on the counter that I was able to squash. And as I was going through, now the light isn't great here, but it's enough for me as I was going through the leaves and then washing them and rinsing them. If I found, you know, the spotted leaves that are like diseased, like really badly spotted, then I took them out. And I really didn't have a lot of sand because these plants were so high and I cut about this high above the ground. So there really wasn't any dirt. And when I was picking them, there was a section of leaf on the top that had bird poop on it, and I didn't bring that inside. So anyways, washed, rinsed twice, and now I'm going to do a drying on the towels. And this is to get all the excess water off. And using a good absorbent bath towel is really helpful for this. And I'm gonna fold it over too. So I got half of the towel to here. I'm gonna talk about lemon balm as I do this. Look at these leaves, look how beautiful they are. So I'll try to get, this is gonna last me years. I will probably end up giving away lemon balm tea. I know my sister really likes it, and she's growing lemon balm this year for the first time. So, man, I'm telling you, it likes shade. That 50% shade, it likes that shaded area. It's growing like a weed, haha. Yeah, it grows like a weed. It is a weed. It's a herb and a good one. Okay, so I'm just going to get as much as a single layer on here. So this was rinsed, washed and rinsed in very cold water, which is good. I was filling up the pot, realized it was hot water. I'm like, no, don't do that. Okay, and then I'm just going to fold this over. And then what I'm going to do, I'm just going to leave this on here, let everything on the bottom drip. And then I'm going to fold it over and flip it over to the other side. So I'm going to do this. And then I'm going to flip it over and let the top part drain. So I'm not going to squish the leaves to get them dry. I'm just going to let them drip like this. And then I'll flip them over and let them dry. And then when the power comes on, they're gonna go in the dehydrator. And in the meantime, I have some nice blueberries that I got from Costco yesterday. And these were washed earlier. I was eating them for breakfast, so I'm gonna go take a break and get some blueberries. So while I'm drying out my lemon balm leaves, and the power's out, I came over here to look at this and I thought, you know what? This is a perfect time to share this with all you, my community. So this here is, it's up here, it's on Velcro. I have a command hook Velcro thing that I put on the back here. And I put this up on my wall. And I come and check this every so often. And this is telling me that my refrigerator right now is at 39 degrees. My freezer is at -3. The garage, inside the garage is 83 degrees, pretty hot. And inside it's 74. So inside here, temperature is 74. And nothing's on. There's no AC on right now or anything. My garage is not insulated, so it's really hot right now. My freezer is still good. My refrigerator, I haven't opened it since the power went out. And when this starts to go up to like 40, then I'm gonna have to put the generator on and put that refrigerator on for a bit to get that cooled down. And I think these are great. I think they're great. So I have this up here. And I think about a month ago, can't remember what happened. Oh, it's crooked. I'll fix it later. I had it up here and it fell to the ground and it smashed. And I gotta straighten this. Hold on. And it smashed and it wrecked the screen here. So I had to buy a whole new system. But that's gonna allow me to show you. Where are the, I know I put the extra ones in here yesterday. Yeah, hold on a sec. My nicely organized pantry. If you haven't seen that. Oh my God. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. What happened here? What is going on? Oh, okay, maybe that's one for the bloopers. I almost lost my camera to the ground. Oh, that's crazy. Wait, okay, this is loose. Everything is loose. What's going on? When I first got my camera, I was outside picking beans in like February. The wind blew my tripod over and it cracked my lens and my lens wouldn't
would not autofocus. And I thought, oh my goodness, I'm gonna have to spend tons of money to buy a new lens. And I knocked it back into place and it started working again. So this is my lens. And you hear a noise in the background. Yes, my power's still off, but I have my Rumba going and it's on battery. So this comes with three of these. And you put this wherever you want. You can put this outside. I could put this outside in my backyard. I have one in my deep freezer. I have one in my refrigerator. I have one in my garage. The reason why I have one in my garage too is because a lot of times in the springtime I'll put my plants out there when I'm hardening them off, and I'll put them in there, and if it's too cold in there, this will tell me the temperature. So the temperature and... what else comes up on it? I think it's the humidity. The humidity and the temperature comes up on this. So I have three extra ones in here because I just needed a new base station. So this is the base station. And you could change it to Celsius or Fahrenheit. And 60% humidity in my fridge, 67% humidity in my freezer, 44% humidity in my garage, and 56% humidity here. And I wonder if that's true. Well, I can't check. My furnace system is off because the power's off. Oh, cat toys. Yes, and my nice clean pantry. Here, I'll show you. I'll prove it to you. Everything's still organized in there. Right, months later. What a day. Okay, I'm turning this off now and I'm gonna go get my Rumba off because it's done doing its cleanup and figure out the rest of the day. All of my lemon balm has been dried in the dehydrator. So I'm gonna take out all of the leaves and put them in this jar. And these are really, really large leaves. And I want to show you the difference of the harvest, my harvest from last year. My lemon balm tea. Now remember, the plants were new, and I put them in those raised garden beds because I needed some harvest for the winter. And so I got all the new growth and I cut it down in the winter. Oops, I'm losing my... But these are the size of the leaves. One leaf. So as a disclaimer, I just want to say I am not a medical professional, and anything I say about lemon balm, you do your own research and you seek medical advice from your doctor. So I'm going to tell you a bit about lemon balm as I do this. When we're making tea, if you're going to take a few leaves, and because these are so big, I would just end up crushing them up. I'm going to put them in this jar, and because of the humidity in the house, I find that these are becoming more pliable than dry. I'm going to put some desiccant little canisters in here to make sure everything stays dry.
Lemon balm. Melissa officinalis. Some of the benefits of lemon balm. Calming effects, reduces stress and anxiety, promotes relaxation, improves mood. Improves sleep, helps with insomnia and other sleep disorders, promotes better sleep quality. Digestive health, eases indigestion and bloating, relieves nausea and upset stomach. Cognitive function, enhances memory and concentration, may protect against cognitive decline. Antiviral properties, effective against cold sores and other viral infections, contains compounds that inhibit the replication of viruses. Antioxidant properties, protects cells from antioxidative stress, may reduce risk of chronic diseases. Pain relief, alleviates headaches and menstrual cramps, reduces discomfort from minor injuries and muscle pain. Skin health, soothes skin irritation and inflammation. Useful in treating insect bites and minor wounds. Now, cautions. Allergic reactions may cause allergic reactions in some individuals. Perform a patch test before using topically. Hypothyroidism may interfere with thyroid hormone levels. Consult a doctor if you have thyroid issues. Sedative effects can cause drowsiness, especially in high doses. Avoid driving or operating heavy machinery after use. Pregnancy and breastfeeding. Limited research on safety during pregnancy and breastfeeding, so consult a healthcare provider before use. Medication interactions may interact with sedatives, thyroid medications, and other drugs. Speak to a healthcare professional if you're on medication. Here are some interesting stories and historical facts about lemon balm. Lemon balm, otherwise known as Melissa officinalis, has been used for over 2,000 years with origins tracing back to the Mediterranean region. Ancient Greeks and Romans valued it for its medicinal properties. Melissa and the bees. The name Melissa comes from the Greek word for bee. Lemon balm has been associated with bees since ancient times because its flowers attract them. Beekeepers in ancient Greece would rub lemon balm on hives to prevent bees from swarming and to encourage them to return to the hive. Charlemagne's mandate. In the 9th century, Emperor Charlemagne ordered the lemon balm to be grown in every monastery garden due to its medicinal benefits and ability to attract bees, which were crucial for honey production. Carmelite water. In the 17th century, the Carmelite nuns in France created Carmelite water, a popular tonic made with lemon balm, lemon peel, nutmeg, and angelica root. It was used to treat a variety of ailments, including headaches, digestive issues, and nervous disorders. Thomas Jefferson's garden. Thomas Jefferson, one of the founding fathers of the United States, grew lemon balm in his gardens at Monticello. He was an avid gardener and valued the plant for its culinary and medicinal uses.
So I use these, especially for my herbs and my dried goods that I'm dehydrating. Because I live in a very humid climate, so I'm gonna put about 3 of these in here. I'm gonna put 1 in here. I think this one might, no, it doesn't.